to reduce one by one, step by step, going on reducing, 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 reducing all these attachments created by our own craving. Now that is what we are doing. Since we cannot throw away at once, practical way, we are trying to take for the discipline, precept, morals, ethics. What are these things? Certain principles for us to uphold, to practice, in order to reduce this craving. So all our precept, commandment, principle, morals are based on this. That means we train ourselves not to become slaves, to maintain our dignity, not to become crazy. So we are training ourselves. The idea is to experience this freedom, salvation, liberation. That is the third noble truth. Before the Buddha started this interpretation, different religious groups had their own interpretation or the method or practices or beliefs. How to gain this liberation? Now this is very interesting. Everybody except the follower of any religion in this world accept that this life creates problems. There is no controversy. That is why they advise you to pray or to believe or to do something to go to heaven. Because this is not a safety place. This is very uncertain. This is miserable. Every religion says. So only solution, according to them, to go to heaven, paradise, moksha, Brahma, four stages. Then they have introduced the method. One religion says, if you want to go to heaven and paradise, you must follow this method. Another religion says, if you want to go attain moksha or Brahma world, you must follow this method. Another religion says, if you want to see the eternal life, immortal life, you must follow this method. When all these methods and beliefs and practices were there at that time, the Buddha had to explain this new method. This is a new discovery. Earlier, no one has given this interpretation. This is the method to find out salvation, liberation, and freedom. Because this is called Nirodha, not heaven, not paradise, not moksha. Now, Christians and Muslims talk about heaven and paradise. But they also believe that this life is very miserable, uncertain, therefore your duty is to go to heaven or paradise. Now, that life is immortal, never die to them. But there are many others who are not ready to accept it. Then another religious group says, heaven or paradise, yes, we know they do exist, but not everlasting. We have to go further. Then they introduce two more words, moksha and Brahma, Now these are the words that many of those existing Indian religions, mostly Indian religion, introduce. Moksha. Moksha is a Sanskrit word, meaning moksha means mukti, or moksha means freedom. Free from suffering. The meaning of the word moksha. For nirvana also, in the Pali language, we use this word. Mokha. That is the Pali language. Mokho nirodho nibbanam deepo tanhakkayo param. These are the words for nirvana. Moksha. But they do not refer to the same nirvanic bliss that the Buddha explained. Although they use the word moksha. Again, Brahma. Union with Brahma. That means we were created by Mahabrahma, a great creator. So this belief was there so many thousands of years in the world, that we were created by God. This is not a new discovery. So we were created by Mahabrahma, creator God. So after purifying, here again difference. All these existing religion divide into two. Semitic religion teach us what we need to find out our salvation is our belief, strong belief, belief in God. And pray. That is enough. So their religions are based on belief and faith. All the other activities are immaterial to them. That is why sometimes when they come and preach, they say, don't worry about your morals and precepts and this and that. Believe in God. Follow Him. That is enough. Based on faith. Then the other religions, especially Buddhism, teaches us. Belief itself doesn't serve the purpose. Very strongly. Your belief can become a blind faith. Your belief can become your imagination. When we analyze in your belief, there is nothing very shallow. You maintain all these beliefs while keeping all your mental impurities. So, Buddhism does not give or does not emphasize the belief or the faith is the most important ingredients for you to find out your salvation. Then what you need? You can forget about your belief. Mental purity. If there is purity in your mind, nothing to worry about your belief. If there is no purity in your mind, after that, life can become miserable. Still you maintain your craving, your anger, your jealousy, your evil forces. While keeping all these evil forces in your mind, you can say, yes, I believe. But Buddhism says, that belief is not enough. Your duty is to cleanse your mind, purify your mind. mind must be pure. When the mind is pure, in that mind, evil forces never appear. Then you are qualified, you are entitled to gain your final salvation, liberation, freedom. So moksha or nirvana must be gained through purity. So the nirodha means that freedom we gain through purity in our mind, not through faith. Then, why is it necessary for us to gain this nirodha? Why is it very difficult for us to maintain this way of life? Now, this is another interesting story. Now, although we experience a lot of suffering, we like to remain here. We like to stay back. Because we are attached, we are bound to this worldly life. Some people ask, if all of us attain nirvana, what will happen to this world? Nobody will look after this world, isn't it? What a pity. See how strong our attachment is. We like to remain here in spite of all the suffering because there is nobody to look after this world. It is like this. Supposing in a hospital, in one particular ward, say about 50 to 75 patients in that hospital. They have been taking medicine. But still, they are suffering. A specialist come from another country and examined all these patients and announced, yes, we have a new discovery, new medicine. I can cure all your sicknesses. Within 1 month, I can send you home. Then, patients feel very happy, and some of those patients think, now, if all of us go away, there is nobody in this world. And these nurses, hospital attendants, and doctors have no work, no job, no salary. Therefore, few of us stay back, others can go home. It's exactly like this. So they are willing to suffer for the sake of nurses and doctors and attendants to stay back. So those who ask this kind of questions are exactly like this, because of attachment. So the problem is this. What guarantee is there that we can continue, we can carry on this way of life without any changes, life after life, go on, continuing like this? Do you think it is possible? It is impossible, in simple language, impossible. You do not know how you exist here in this world today. How you came to this world, and you never realize how fortunate you are today. Compare with others. Think for a while. Although you grumble, still you are very, very fortunate. What? You can see. You can hear. You can climax. Peak of the mountain. All the other living beings are below. So what guarantee is there that Again, you never fall down.